Since the last study shows that the fear of being judged or rejected by a particular person or group of person was the reason why people restricted their breathing, so they created such scenario in which that fear of that particular person will be triggered. For the research purpose, a room was set wherein a participant was sitting. Say for example, we'll call him a listener. So each and every participant of that group of 32 people used to visit that particular room, sit in front of the chair of that particular listener. And the participant were instructed that they need to tell to the listener something in their life they are passionate about until the timers go off, and the timer was set to 2 minutes. And on the other hand, the listener was instructed not to show any emotions and not to make eye contact to the participant. The 32 participants were divided into two groups, 16-16. Say for the sake of simplicity, we'll call the team Exhale and the team Gratitude. Team Exhale were instructed to notice when their breathing becomes restricted during that particular interrogation and to immediately exhale through a non-voice sigh through their mouth and to inhale via their nose and to continue to speak about what they are passionate about. Team Gratitude was told the same thing. In addition, they were asked to keep focusing upon how grateful they were that they got to share what they are passionate about to that listener. And they were also told to keep believing no matter what that the listener was also grateful to hear what they are passionate about. Now, before and after the exercise, the participant documented three things. One, their level of stress on the scale 1 to 10, wherein 10 was being highly anxious. Two, their level of awareness on the scale 1 to 10, wherein 10 was highly aware, mindful and conscious. And three, the journal documented their thoughts, what were present in their mind. Looking at the data, this is what they found. The team Exhale were throughout in the restricted breathing while they were talking to that particular listener, and team Gratitude was shifting from being restricted breathing to full deep breathing and again to restricted breathing and then to the full deep breathing. At their level of stress on speaking on average, team Exhale reported a rise in 1 to 1.5 jump in their level of stress, while team Gratitude reported 1.5 to 2 points drop in their level of stress. Regards to awareness after speaking in approx, team Exhale reported 1.5 decrease in the awareness, while team Gratitude reported 1.5 point increase in the awareness. Let's examine the post-exercise recorded thoughts. Team Exhale recorded thoughts were centered on themselves and how restricted their breathing still was and how the listener was a real big jerk. Team Gratitude were centered on how grateful they are that they have this thing in their life they are passionate about. And they wanted to know more about the listener, especially because they thought the listener was socially awkward and weird. They saw him with the eyes of empathy and curiosity.
So, this proves that this gratitude breathing is more powerful than just deep breathing to counteract our restricted breathing and to move into a state of being that is more conducive to good health, positive moods, and mindfulness. So this idea of gratitude breathing is that no-take life hack I want to share it with you.